Hello everyone, welcome to a new Legacy video. We are playing today a sweet deck that seems in play from Julian Nab and other popular streamers in Legacy, and got my attention, and I always wanted to play it, but online, RX of Agers, Lance and Diamond combo, it's kind of awkward. So how does this work? 4 mana, 2, 4, pay 2 to return an artifact to your hand. So if you return Lance and Diamond, you just have infinite mana. You have infinite mana, but you have no hand, so you have to do something with that infinite mana. So what do? You can just have a walking ballista laying around, you just return that through your hand, and you just kill them. Or you can have a card creator in play, you can just get the ballista out from the sideboard and get, or get Mikos in Tlatis, or, you know, get Lionside Diamond from the sideboard thanks to current great creator. And, you know, just win, you know, just, basically current great creator finds you the one piece of the combo, and also finds you the win con, which is pretty cool. The rest of the deck is just dirtling around, 19 lands, 4 Ancient Den, 4 Ancient Tomb, 4 Cavern of Souls, 4 City of Traders, 2 Caracas, and 1 Plains. So basically we try to push as much as possible a card in turn 2. And we can do that either with the lands or with Lotus Petals and Mox Opals. We do have our mismatching Mox Opals here, and we do have a lot of artifacts like Mishra's Bauble and Urza's Bauble, which can just make you so that you get to Metalcraft better. The bubbles are also good in your case. You go infinite mana with Rex of Agers, Landslide Diamond, you can just return bubbles. And sure, you're not gonna draw cards immediately because the Urza's Bauble is like the Mishra's Bauble. Just draw a card in your opponent turn, but you're gonna draw like, you know, a very large amount of cards like the turn after. And yeah, so we have 4 mana 3 Mentor, which is, you know, it's 16-0 drops. Could be fine. With Chalice of the Void, of course, because like any deck with Ancient Tomb should also have Chalice of the Void. And yeah, 4 cards and of Urza, because a Construct token here is pretty large. It's actually funny that this deck is playing a lot more Sand of Urza than Great Creator. And it's not, the Legacy is not like Vintage. There's not artifacts on the other side of the table most of the time, so the activate abilities can't be used. It's less relevant. Yeah, this deck is very cool, and see, let's see if it also works. Like, on paper it works, right? But let's see if it also works. It's gonna work on in a field. And the sideboard does a bunch of artifacts, Tormod's Crypt, and Snaring Bridge, and then Diamond Walking Ballista, Amigos, and Lattice, also to get them with Karn. And then there's a bunch of white cards. Plow, I guess, against, like, Delver. Containment Priest against Reanimator, and a couple of Cast Out, which are weird. I'm gonna assume we're gonna bring them in against, I don't know, just Jace or Narset decks, I don't know. And yeah, that's the deck. Let's head down to a Legacy competitive league. But before that, remember that this is ChannelFireball.com. So please, if you support us, content producer, please make sure to check out the website. And in case you wanna buy any new Modern Horizon card, you know, we have them. All right, this is the classic Ancient Tomb Chalice hand, which no one in the history of Magic has ever mulliganed. And of course, if it was not play, it would have just been probably just a turn one kill. But it's on the draw, so we're gonna likely just get. Oh, actually, no, we can play around. We can play around Dates, which is pretty cool. Which is pretty cool indeed. So we're gonna just lay out some jewelries. If they date my Mox Opal, I'm not that unhappy. Definitely gonna play around Dates in this matchup. I don't care if it loses life. We just drew Karn, which means that I'm just very close to just play Amigos and Tlatis here. I'm criminally close to play Mega Saint Lattice here. Alright, so they don't have Force of Will, so my Chalice of the Void is in. To reveal Ponder, fair enough. Wasteland, my Ancient Tomb away. I'm gonna definitely draw a card off the Mishra's Bauble. And now this is a clock, but then there's a 6 turn clock, and hopefully they don't play any other spell for the rest of the game. I still have 3 artifacts, so alright, Locating Calend on top, that's fine. So we're looking for. Sure, just surround the lands here. That's what you're looking for. I think I'm gonna cycle again this bubble. Or do they have a 2-drop? Oh, they do. Ugh. Ay, ay, ay. 12. Alright, I need to combo soon here because. Alright, at least they don't draw next turn because there's a chain lining. Petal, nice. What do you want to play, the Great Creator or Sign of Urza? The Great Creator can go get me. Can go get me Amigos and Lattice, but I can just still attack through me. We can go get me a bridge. I guess that's better, right? Yeah. Let's play the Great Creator. Because, I mean, sure, I could play around Days if I play the other one, but I don't think I have enough time to just play around Days. Alright, so if I take a bridge here, I should be in a great spot. Wait. I could have used Lanza Dama to play bridge. I don't think I can. I should have definitely done that. I forgot about it. So I should have just, once this is resolved, I should have just cracked Lanza Diamond, get the bridge, and then play the bridge with empty board. Alright, this is the first mistake. let's hope to not get more. But then we know they draw chain lining, so we should be good here. Sure, you know, we lose Karn Great Creator, which would have just won us the game next turn. Maybe with the Mikos and Lattice. But we know they don't have a forceful foot in hand, so they just have a chain lining now that we saw with a bubble. We lost a Karn, which is a pretty big deal. And also, like, they can still attack us through the bridge. Alright. Let's name, what is that, human? Alright. Let's name a human, which is Oryx of Agers. Yeah, I guess, let's play bridge. And now, had I had played bridge last turn, I just drew a Lanzai Diamond, so I would have played, I would have just minus two, get the Mikos and Lattice, and played it with the 6 mana that I actually have access to, 7 mana. Because I would have cracked the Lanzai Diamond last turn. But yeah, so. Alright, game is gonna be a little bit longer here, but I think we're still gonna be in a pretty good shape. Them not drawing Force of Will is definitely very good for us. And this is the strength of Karn Great Creator. I don't know why it's playing 4 of these and 3 of that. I guess we'll figure it out at some point, because, you know, this list, I think it's kind of tuned. I've been seeing Julian playing this deck a lot, and he just 5-1 the Legacy Challenge with. Alright. Okay, what do I want to do here? It's either Karn or Monster Mentor. I think I'll play Mentor. I think I'll play Mentor here. The way Lanzai Diamond work is obviously not a Black Lotus, so you can't just play it. You just use its mana to cast the spells, but with the Karn Great Creator was, you know, it's a pretty good combo. Alright, do they have something? They could have like a 2 mana burn spell, like a Fire and Ice, or what is this? Hopefully they have Price of Progress, because I wouldn't lose to that, but eventually I would, because I have to play land for this bridge. Alright, what is it? 2 mana? A braid. On the bridge. Yeah, I guess I just lost. Yeah, I would have just easily won this game. Kind of a bummer. Well, maybe I haven't lost yet. Alright, I have not lost yet. I haven't lost yet. Alright, so let's draw. What do we want to draw here, actually? I don't know. I could have used the. Wow. Alright. So. I think I just won here. It's pretty impressive. So. Play the Arts of Agers. I'll float some white mana. And now I have infinite mana. And infinite tokens. And infinite clicks. And this is honestly the main reason why I never wanted to play this deck. Like Julian and Jarvis as well, and I think about it. They want me to play with this deck. I mean, they want me. They asked me. They told me to play with this deck because it was good. But I was like, yeah, but I just don't want to put myself through the thing of doing this over and over. And they were like, yo, but it's not gonna happen. And I'm like, yeah, it is going to happen. Because now basically we have to click like 30 times each click. Like this is literally like 30 times of clicking me to get 30 mana. And it's not that you don't need this much mana. Because it's not about the mana now, it's just about me making tokens. Because I want to make, I don't know, just like 30 tokens or something. So here we're using the mana, but we're not actually using it. So we're getting the mana, but we're not actually using it. We're just, I don't know, I wanna. Also rather tilted because I could have won this game way earlier had I remembered that Lensite Diamond combos with Concrete Creator. And there's not even a fast way to do this actually, so. And my opponent goes like, you know, I don't want to concede because they have their Delver and they can just draw. I don't know honestly what can they draw, but it's right that I'm not conceding. In paper this works very well, right? Because you just do, okay, I have, 200 tokens, I have 200 mana, I draw, you know, a lot of cards because of Mishra's Bauble. Because now, after, I can also just, now that I have enough mana, I could just get Bauble and start drawing a little bit. Yeah. Like, I'm gonna return a Mishra's Bauble. Play it. I'll look at the top of their deck and the top of my deck just to do something. Alright, it's a wasteland, so basically nothing. But yeah, I think the Arcs of Ages there were just the actual only card to matter, so that was pretty lucky. What's in my top of the deck? It's a Bauble. Alright. I might just even stop at some point because what happens is even if I get a lot of tokens, like next turn I can do this again. I guess they could kill my Oryx of Agers, I'm not pumping my tokens. I'm still drawing a lot of cards though, so I think this is enough. Yeah, I'm just gonna stop here. I'm just gonna actually stop here. Alright, I'm just gonna stop here. I'll float the last ones. Yeah, I'm gonna return. I'm gonna just return a bunch of things in my hand and just passing the turn here. Alright. Yeah, that's okay. I'm gonna pass, I guess. I guess I can attack. Alright, so I'm on 4 life, they have a Delver. I draw just 3 cards. I know I could have drawn more, I just don't want to lose more time. Yeah, Walking Ballista. They just let it through? Alright, I mean, they could have just blocked, it's not it. Alright. Okay, I concede. Yeah, it's because this, like, yeah, we had infinite ways to win the game, but we just decided to just leave last very turn to top deck the Arcs of Ages. But yeah, I guess this is a, you know, first game when a new deck, it's always kind of hard to find yourself. Okay, so I think I like Plows and that's it. I think I like, maybe I can board out one Sign of Words and a couple of Bauble. Yeah, I think that's reasonable. Let's go with this. Alright, what's this? Sure. Yeah, this is another hand where I'm just very close to infinite mana, even though I don't do much with it. Alright. So they got a Delver. I keep on drawing Plows. This could have been the Bauble, so maybe, you know, boarding out Bauble was not the greatest. Yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna go human and pass the turn. I don't really wanna go pedal and plowing a Delver with a pedal. I kinda just wanna use a natural mana to plow the Delver. Alright, so they're gonna. The Delver's gonna flip next turn. It's not now, though. So I just take one damage here, which is good. Mm-hmm, they don't shuffle. Do they have a Wasteland? They do. Alright, bye bye, Cavern. And Ancient Tomb. Alright, so I could go Congregate Creator this turn. But do I want to do that? I don't think so. Maybe I just want to plow this turn, and I can go card next turn. I think I'll do that. I'm gonna keep on naming humans. I think I'll plow it with this. It's not great, but I think this will buy me a couple of turns, because this time around it's gonna flip for sure. And I think after all, with a combo deck, it's not that bad to just buy some turns, especially if I have Cavern. It's not a given that I want to just play Arcs of Ages next turn, because that could have like a Dismember or... I mean, the new card that's in Modern Horizon is definitely going to see play. The 6 mana Delve would deal 5 damage to target creature or Planeswalker. That card will definitely see play in both Vintage and... Alright, if I had a Mentor here, I could just, you know, laid out a bunch of these. But I don't. So I'm going to just go Urza's Bauble. I think I just look at the random card from their hand and, you know, just decide. Oh, Trinum Nemesis. So I could play a card, but I could have a Spell Pierce. I could play an Arcs of Ages with this petal. Yeah, this, why not, right? Why not, right? If I draw Lancet Diamond, I just go off. Like, Lancet Diamond, they can't counter anything. Because I just had 3 mana, and then I just ordered this Bauble, so I have basically infinite cards. Alright, I drew another Bauble, sure. I'm basically just either one Lion's Head Diamond away or just resolving Karn to get Lion's Head Diamond. I don't know, playing as Blue Red Delver, so I'm not afraid of removal spell on a 2-4. Like Arcs of Ages being a 2-4 just means that they can't Lightning Bolt it. Sure, they can go double Lightning Bolt. That'd be bad, but also like a Wasteland could have been awful. Because now, you know, I would have played Ancient Tomb no matter what, so I just cracked the pedal. That was the only difference. Alright, Lancet Diamond. Alright. I think I'll play Seed of Traitors. Sure, like, it's not the greatest, but... Actually, I could maybe take a look at my deck. To see if I need to play Seed of Traitors or not. I'm not attacking here, I'm not interested in trading 2 damage. For 1. Let's see if this flips. They have a Mystery Rainforest. They flip with a Brainstorm, fair enough. They cast it. And now they definitely need to find a Force of Will or a Daze or a Spell Pierce or whatever for my card. But again, if they have a Lionside Diamond, I guess if I have a Lionside Diamond and I counter it, I need a White Source to buy back, which I don't have currently, which is funny because we draw 4 lands. How many White Source does this deck have? 3, 7. Yeah, I guess not that many. I mean, we have Mox Opals. Maybe we could play less. I don't know. Cavern of Souls is pretty good, though. And this deck redraws a lot, so I think all in all, just sees a lot of cards. I decided to cut 2 Bauble, but just because I think those are the 2 weaker cards, not because, you know. Also, this deck doesn't really need the white mana for anything. Because this is a human. So the white mana is necessarily only for the sideboard. Alright, so to resolve the Brainstorm, I play Scalyntar, and I go to 14. I'm very happy I just used the pedal for the plow there. Alright, let's take a look at whatever, their deck. My deck doesn't matter, I'm gonna draw a card now. Alright, this is Lightning Bolt. Alright, let's go for Congregate Creator. They'll definitely force this, or, I mean, they'll probably die. Like, sure, yeah, you could have, like, the Spell Pierce and they could Spell Pierce this, but if they don't have it, they're just dead. So I think it's good to just put them on the spot here. Alright. Yep, that resolves, and they got 18. Once again, if I draw a Lancet Diamond, I don't win, because I don't have a Walking Ballista around, but I just have Infinite versus Bauble, which basically will mean that I draw infinite cards in their turn. I mean, not the infinite, or I deck myself, but like, you know, 40. But if they clock me enough, I'll just die. Because I go to 11 now, next turn is 6. So I think I have like this turn, and that's it. Or Ancient Den. I'm gonna play Karn Sign of Urza. It's gonna stick deeper for the Lanzai Diamond. Alright, we'll do a reveal. Walking Body is a Lotus Petal. If I get Lotus Petal here, which is likely, I'm just gonna plow that Insectile Aberration immediately. Alright. So I have another Walking Ballista, so if I draw Lanzai Diamond, I win now, because I have the Walking Ballista beneath the Karn Sign of Urza. Alright, Dreadnought Arcanist is not bad with the Lanzai Diamond. Sorry, with Lightning Bolt. Right, who do they attack? Me, probably, because they're probably dead. I probably dead next turn on Lanzai Diamond. Alright, am I dead here now? I think I am, right? Well, I can't... yeah. So I can't return the Lotus Petal to my hand, right? What do I do with it? Nothing. I can't return the Urza's Bauble, draw a card, and then block this, but that'll just Lightning Bolt the Arcs of Aegers, and then I have no outs. Alright, my out could be to... so if I just take this Walking Ballista and play for one, then I can block the Dread Arcanist. They Lightning Bolt me face, go to 5, attack me down to 2, and I'm just super dead here. I don't think there's, even if I draw two, even if I reveal two Lanzai Diamond here, yeah, alright, good game. So I just dead here. They go to 5, they attack me down to 2, and then they just rebuy this Lightning Bolt. Alright, good game. The combo deck didn't get through, but you know that happens. I think I'm very happy with the plows, like they bought me a lot of time. I don't think I want to change anything. I think I like everything. Even the Monster Mantle looks, I think looks pretty good. Maybe I can cut one Monster Mantle. I think this Urza's Bauble are very important for the Opal. I wouldn't sideboard in many out. Let's go with this. Alright, I'll go first. And sure, we have a turn on Chalice, so they basically like have to counter it immediately, or a big chunk of their deck gets countered. And sure, they could have braided, but means that I can start playing 3 drops on turn 3. It's not... Like, look at my hand. It doesn't only do Chalice of the Void, it also does a turn 2 Karn Sign of Urza. Which I could not do if I want to play around something. They're on 4 cards, so I might just want to play it slow. Yeah, I'm only going to 4, but that's really what happens with... either with, like, you know, 18 lands deck, with like 4 wastelands, so sometimes you just don't draw your lands, or some other times you just look for Cyber Hate and you just end up just mulligan into Oblivion. Alright, so I don't really want to play Karn Sign of Urza here, because that could have days. And let's just play it slow. I'm just gonna play Ancient Den and play Mog Fanatic, which I like to call this, so that, you know, I just have it around once I go Arcs of Aegers plus Lanzai Diamond. Or if they play a Pyromancer, I can melee kill it. If they play Dreadnought Arcanist, that's okay. I mean, I can go Karn Sign of Urza minus and just play a 3-3 construct. Alright. So we got a win here, I think. I don't think there's much they can do about this win. Right? So I just cast this. If this resolves, then I have the win. Yeah, surgical maybe. Not even. Like, what do the surgical? I mean, I can surgical Walking Ballista maybe. Walking Ballista is in my. Yeah, I'm just gonna. So the surgical does it. So let's see. I have 1 mana floating. So I crack Lanzai Diamond. 4 mana floating. So I can activate this twice. So not even surgical does it. Oh, actually, they can't cast surgical. What am I talking about? All right, let's just go for the win. Yeah, I should definitely just play Lanzai Diamond just in case it goes like double days or something. All right, and then what I have here is just infinite mana with Lanzai Diamond, Arcs of Aegers, and then I just shoot Walking Ballista, and then I just return it, and then I have, and then I win. So yeah, pretty cool thing. Let's go back to this thing, and let's go to round number 2. It's been a while they haven't won a die roll on this league. Last time I recorded was at Grace's Control, went 0-5 in die rolls, and today was 0-2. It's quite important. So playing against Chancellor, I would have easily won the game if I wasn't the play. Because, like, Black Red Reanimator, I mean, not easily, but it has a very hard time to deal with a Charizard 1. I remember playing Eldrazi the PT. I was lucky enough to win the die roll there, and I was playing against Alderaan, and I just went Charizard 1 on the play, and that just basically died, because basically what happens is they can't cast a lot of their ways to put things in the graveyard, so the only ways to put things in the graveyard was to discard, and he already mulliganed 2/6, so it took like 2 turns to discard, and meanwhile it just like thought and seared them, and like, you know, it was rather easy. Alright, speaking of other things here, I think I can easily beat the Chancellor, very likely with just a Karn. I don't know, so let's see. What do I do here? I think I play this versus Bobble, let them counter it with the, because remember, that's the Chancellor trigger. I think having Lance and Eminem play is more relevant than having this versus Bobble. So this is countered, alright, bye bye. And then what? So I could play, I guess I'm just playing Chalice on 1, just call it a day, hoping they have just, I don't know, reanimate or stuff. Remember, Chalice on 1, you can flash back the Faithless Looting. And just play everything so that if I draw a Slagers, I win. And I can't discard my hand anymore. I mean, I can't go, that can go Mask actually. But next turn, I'll try my best to go Concrete Creator. And I don't know there what I want to do because. So let's see, if they go like Exhume or Animate Dead, they can't reanimate the Chancellor. Otherwise, the reanimate can't go work because of Chalice. Then reanimate Chancellor means that. Maybe I should just get a bridge. Should just get a bridge. Cause like once I have Caracas down, what does care me? Maybe just Tidespell Tyrant. Alright, let's see how this goes. Cabal Therapy. It's not the best start, opponent. Not the best start. They thought a lot and then bam, Cabal Therapy. And Exhume. Okay. Sure. They got a Chancellor, mm-hmm, and then they pass. All right, I go. Arx of Aegis. It's what they call a good draw. All right, I think we got this. Cause this has counter, right? So basically, I drew infinite cards. What happened this turn is that I draw infinite cards. I think that will be good enough. I think to win. Because I can go Cavern of Souls plus Arx of Aegis, I don't have to pay. Then you have 3 white. I guess I don't get infinite mana. Because every bubble costs 1. So I just don't go up in mana, but I just draw infinite cards. And with infinite cards, I'll eventually find a win next turn. With just Lanzai Diamond, I think. Right? Oh no, maybe, wait. I don't get infinite mana because I pay 2 to return this, to return the Lanzai Diamond, but then I can't return also this because I don't have the mana to do that. So what I can do here is, it's very hard actually now to beat this Chancellor. It's very hard to beat Chancellor. Like I can tap the Seat of Traitors, play a Cavern of Souls, and I can't play Karn, guys, I can't play Karn. So this is very bad. I can't pick up it costs 1 more. I guess I can pay Karn with Lanzai Diamond. And then what? I just take the bridge. But then I'm so far away from casting bridge because bridge costs 4. Because remember, Chancellor. Right? So it is in my graveyard. Sure, it does a Tormod's Crypt. It doesn't do much now that the thing is already in play. And that's not legendary. I do have a Lanzai Diamond in my graveyard, but I don't think it does it. So I think what I'm gonna do here is just cast this Arx of Aegis and just pass the turn. So I'll name humans. It's dead. Play Arx of Aegis and pass the turn. Cause again, I had 3 mana. Let's try to repeat. I had 3 mana. I pay 2, I return the Lanzai Diamond. What I do is just cast infinite spell. Because I don't net mana. So yeah, I'm just passing. I can't cast this card, of course, because this is not a Black Lotus. I have a reasonable clock on me, like 4-turn clock. It's not a good draw. I'll play Caracas and... Alright, I can return the pedal. Next turn I can play the pedal. So what I can do here is crack Lanzai Diamond, get 3 mana. Return what? I don't think that brings me anywhere, right? It doesn't bring me anywhere. This one says every spell costs one more. It doesn't mean bring me anywhere. I mean, I might be missing something, and I hope I really don't, because, you know... It's kind of funny, because I have the combo, but that doesn't bring me anything, because it's just Chancellor next in play. Just passing the turn here, and end of turn I'm gonna get back pedal. The turn after, I can play the pedal. Basically, Lola Louis is just hoping to draw lands, so I can cast this Karn. And eventually just get the win with like a bridge. I don't need to get backwards this bobble. I just gonna get back a pedal. Alright, draw. Something good, please. Karn Santa Versa, that's very bad. Okay. Yes. Alright, so if I draw a Ancient Overseer of Traders, I don't think it does it. I don't think it does it still. I don't think it does it. I don't think it does because I don't have enough mana to then do the other thing. Mentor maybe would have done it. So I can play Karn, crack the Lion's Eye Diamond to pay the 1 mana more. It's really a bummer that I'm losing this game. Maybe if I draw on a... If I draw a Walking Ballista? No. Alright, let's try to see how does this work. So I pay this, I play this, I crack this for white, I pay one, this resolves, then I have 2 money in my pool. So I can get Lion's Eye Diamond. So I pay 2 mana, I return let's see. So I get Lanzai Diamond. I don't even know where I'm going, guys. I don't even know where I'm going. So I pay 1. I mean, now it's probably nowhere, right? Now I just have a bunch of mana, and that's it. Now I just have a bunch of mana, not even that much. And I can't use it. Yeah, no, I don't think there was a way out. Pretty sad. I just lost to the Chancellor, which is not legendary, and made basically stop my combo. All right, so I want Containment Priest, maybe over Monastery Mentor. I think I want to cut the bubbles. Maybe over Karn Sound of Urza, actually. No, there's so many Sound of Urzas in this deck. Okay, yeah, let's just go with this. Alright, on the play, again, if we're on the play, that last game could have easily won. Alright, this is a great end. So, I'm debated between playing Chalice on 1 or just playing Containment Priest on 1. Chalice on 1 stops a lot of things. Really stops a lot of things. I'm just gonna go with Chalice on 1, honestly. Like, once we have Chalice on 1, we get so much time. And we have 2 Containment Priest, so not even, like, an Unmask stops this. Basically, all we need is just a Mana Source, not even a land. Alright, I could play 2 drops. Could be, like, an Abrupt Decay, but, you know. I'd rather just play this than Containment Priest if they have Abrupt Decay, because basically this tops Mario Mask Me. Okay. So they see double condemn embrace, that's not bad. And like, you know, if let's say we have a containment priest in play, that can just go like faithless looting, like digs for their answer for containment priest. And you know, it's not that easy. You sure probably could just go to discard and then turn two, just reanimate. That's also a possibility, but not what happened. Alright, so it's cutting one containment priest. They can discard the other containment priest with another unmask. Unless they, I think, are kind of troublesome. Alright. We even cut three expensive cards. We even cut three expensive cards from our deck. We cut two Karn and the Mentor. This one could have been the most expensive one ever. Alright, so hopefully they have a Ascensus Trophy and not like Abrupt Decay. Alright. No, maybe just Wear Tear. Ah, if they have Wear Tear. Alright, green. Come on, Ascensus Trophy, please. It makes sense to have Ascensus Trophy, right? Yes, nice. The Ascensus Trophy can deal with Ascensus Trophy can deal with Leyline. Alright, going to Tomb, but I think I'm gonna go just Containment Priest now. I guess no, we're not talking about it. Yeah, it's just that's flash, yeah. Now I was thinking about if they reanimate the instant speed, but that deck doesn't play any reanimation instant speed. So let them put whatever in the graveyard, like a Caracas, like a... I guess I can put Chancellor. A Grisabrand is good, but you don't have Caracas for that. Like, if game one they would have reanimated Grisabrand, I'm not sure they would have won, because I just had the kill next turn. Alright, I think I'm gonna go Containment Priest here. Also just attacking it something. Like, if next turn I draw land, I can play just Monster Mentor and beat down. Alright, Lotus Petal. Yeah, I'm gonna go for Monster Mentor here. Because like they need to find an answer to Containment Priest, you know, which they might not have, or they might have, but it takes a while, and in the meanwhile, we just kill them. Because people underestimate on how important it is to clock these combo decks. Like, for example, when I was playing Sneak and Show, you know, I was playing against Miracles, I was playing against a good player that consistently played turn 2 Snapcaster Mage, just to pressure me, and that was like, I was impressed all the time. Alright, I draw the best card here, because I'm gonna go Concord Creator, get a... Wait, did I just not bring in Thormos Crypt? Alright, I just forgot to bring in Thormos Crypt, alright. Not gonna forget this time around, sorry for that, guys. I'm gonna bring all the Thormos Crypt, because the Karn sign of the Concord Creator... Sure, I can go Karn Thormos Crypt like I would have done now, but I'm on the draw, and I think this is just too slow, you know, too slow. So I'm just gonna go do this. And I think I'll board out all the you know, all the expensive things and just try to win. Necessarily just with the... I guess I can board out Walking Ballista over Mentor. Walking Ballista does kill opponent though. Which is pretty big deal. It's a pretty big deal. Alright, I'm gonna go with this. Sorry for the forgetting Thormos Crypt, but luckily we didn't get punished. Alright, we got another turn one Chalice. We don't have any heavy sideboard though, but it's the fact that we are on the draw, my opponent could just play a discard spell, I'm not gonna mulligan this hand. We don't have any ley line to mulligan into, so like you can just mulligan into Cyber Hate and then just discard it, which is like the worst feeling. Or you could just, you know, die of mulliganing. Like, I'm pretty, like, you know, I don't mulligan too much. And you know, one of the reasons is that, yeah, alright. We might just die, but it's not that having a Containment Priest or Tormod Crypt in our 4-card hand it would have saved us. Cause that's Reanimator, like that deck exists, and that's the reason why, you know, Blue is the best deck, because it's the only deck that could actually interact with these. I mean, I guess Leyline and Surgical also interact with these, but... Chancellor? Alright. I can beat that with the Karn Sign of Urza into Bridge. They only give me two mana, two turns. Wow, that's impressive. They decided to reanimate that over Grisabrand. Containment Priest, there it is. It was just there all the time. It was just chilling. Alright, so I can't play Chalice. I'm just gonna go for... And if you wonder to board in Plow, no, don't do that. Don't board in Plow for Chancellor, okay, guys? Alright, so we have a third turn clock here, which eventually will just kill us, but... And if you play Reanimator on the play, just go Grazer Brand, guys. I guess our opponent might have played around Surgical, but we play Chalice, we cannot play Surgical. There's no way we'll play these two cards in the same deck. It's got a trophy wide, it must have like 20,000 trophies. Unfortunately, we drew the planes. Getting ramp would have been very good, but they might not even care about the containment priest. It's Dark Reach on top. Alright. Unfortunately, the combo here is not a consideration because it's only about. Yeah, again, like the way I win is just. Karn. Yeah, I don't think there is actually a way I win. So, the way I win is Karn Bridge, which means that I have to cast Karn next turn, like for sure. So, the only out to do that is. How do I cast Karn this next turn? It was just a Placid of Traitors this turn. It was the only out. So I guess I kind of just... I think take 10, then 5, no. Alright, whatever. Let's pass the turn. I'll play this Containment Priest. I was thinking about Mox Opal to just play some artifacts now, but I can't even play them, because... You know, I would need to play the Chalice on 0, and then the Walking Ballista on 1 cost 3, so yeah. Alright, Lotus Petal. I go to 5, yeah, there's no chances I do it, right? There's no chance to do it, right? Because I go to 5 here and then I die. Alright, good game. We just died to Chancellor over the next two games. Pretty bad beats. Let's go to round number 3. Before that, remind you, this is ChannelFireball.com. And ChannelFireball.com does not only sell cards, but also buy cards. So go to ChannelFireball.com/buylist because you can trade with them for a 30% store credit bonus. And our streak of losing Darrels continues. I guess that's because I pointed out. Maybe if I didn't point it out, I wouldn't have lost so many Darrels. We're on 0-8 streak right now and ChannelFireball videos. Alright, we have a turn 1 Chalice, which is obviously a keep. And despite having nothing else with it, but I'm happy with it. Alright, I'm probably just playing against Sneak and Show, but it's okay. I definitely don't want a Chalice on 0 because it's so good. I mean, it's so good against our deck. Like, we have a 18-0 drop, 17-0 drop, or 19-0 drop, I think. Alright, I go Force, Pitch Force. Sure. I played Pond Pedal because they could have a Daze, and you know how, like, Delver deck loses to that. Alright, let's Dreadnought Arcanist, alright. So I was afraid I was playing a Sneak and Show, but it's not. So I'm now happier. Alright, we're gonna play Cavern on. No, I think I'll keep Cavern in my hand. Because I could go Wasteland on the one on humans. I don't care about this construct to resolve, honestly. Alright, now I can't resolve any one drop, so the Dreadnought Arcanist is definitely less. Wait, did I just concede the game 1 where there was a Chalice? No, there was. No. What am I talking about? Alright, even done attack. Don't even attack. Okay, so they could play an Upbraid because you saw how they played it in the previous game. So I'm gonna just play another Chalice here. And I don't need to play Lord Lines of Diamond. So I just pass. This time around I get attacked. They don't need to flashback, so I just go 19. And we just do something else. Play a land. And play Pyromancer. That's good. I'll try my... Ooh, Conqueror Creator. Alright. I think I'm gonna go for just Walking Ballista, shoot the Pyromancer. I don't need to. They drew this now. I don't think they have another threat in their hand. Alright, just cast a Brainstorm. Fair enough. Oh, Lightning Bolt, sure. Alright, I got that cast countered. It's a very long long clock. Alright, I'll lose another land. Bye bye. And I'm gonna just slowly win this game. I think. Like, I only need to achieve 4 lands. Alright, there it is. And this time around, I'm not gonna forget about a Karn Bridge combo. Alright, so that's a bridge with zero cards in hand. Pass, and now we are just riding this car into the victory. Slowly but surely. We can even just animate the bridge. No, we don't. We don't want to do that. So play mentor. Yeah, whatever. Play mentor, which is obviously a good draw. I'm gonna go Lanzai Diamond. And play it. Got a token. So that if they somehow deal with my bridge, like they did in game one, I can block this time around. And now, just gonna pick this up a couple of times and then gonna get the Mycosynth Lattice. And that's gonna be it. Alright, I can see. Basically what happened here is just I just plus one, and the next turn I just sacrifice this for three, pay six, and get Mycosynth Lattice. And then it's a combo. Every permanent is an artifact and card just makes them unable to tap, so they can't play anything anymore for the rest of the game. Effectively. Alright, so this was a convincing victory. I'm gonna board in Source of Plowshares, and that's it. I'll board out Karn, Mentor, and Bubble. That's what I did. I think that's fine. Just diversify your threats. Just cut something. Yeah, that's good. Let's go with this. Alright. Sure, I mean, it's not the best of the hands. I don't know. We don't have Chalice for the first time, but I guess also why we're getting so close to win every single game, because our opponents never are able to play their cards. It's pretty sad. Like, if decks like this are good, I don't know. I think it's good that those decks kind of exist, but it's not good that those decks are good, because it's pretty bad to not make your opponent play Magic. Alright, I'm gonna play Caracas, and I'll probably just pass. I don't need to play other things. Like, I have a Mentor. So next turn I could go, like, Petal, Resolves, Common Souls, Neumans, top 3 Mentor, Lead, get 2 tokens. That's pretty good. And, like, even if they bolt my Monster Mentor, ooh. Now I wish I went for Caracas. For Cavern. Because they could have a Force of Will for my Mentor. But I don't think that's so annoying if they do that. Yeah, I'm actually gonna do that. I'm gonna play around only these. I'm not gonna play around Force. Okay? Yeah, I think this is better. I make one less token. But I think just saving the Petal is relevant with a hand like this. Especially against a deck with Wasteland. Okay, went for the thing, but like next turn I can just go Karn, Great Creator, Lion's Eye Diamond, get a bridge. Or even just they're looking for brain for Wasteland here. So like if I had a bunch of tokens in play of the Mentor, maybe they just had the Lightning Bolt, because like you keep it in. And just Lightning Bolt that, and then what do I do with a token? I guess it just like blocked I stop the Emperor Master from attacking. Alright, I have two cards in it only, so yeah, I'm just gonna go for I don't really want to just waste all my hand though. Let's see what I draw. Alright, so let's play the Great Creator. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for Bridge actually. Cause it's just such an easy win if they don't have like a counter or an abrade, because they just go Bridge this turn and next turn I go Mycosynth Lattice. Or actually I could go Mycosynth Lattice this turn around. Oh my god, I made such a mistake. Alright, this league I'm not playing well, so I'm just ready for all the comments saying how bad I am. If I play Lion's Eye Diamond, I just win, because I can just crack the Lion's Eye Diamond to pay for the spell Pierce. Alright, why do I slow roll this Lion's Eye Diamond so much? It just doesn't make sense. I even played around spell Pierce often in my other games. Alright, it's a Wasteland. Sure, it's awful. I'm gonna lose now. Ah, Mengu, why? Alright, it's kind of proving how this deck can win even through some mistakes here and there. Like in the first game of the league, we did make that mistake, but luckily we just got away with it. Alright, they don't waste on me? Really? Maybe that Force of Win hand and they want to. Alright, just play Karn of Urza. I mean, I'm actually that on board. I'm just that on board. Like, I can go plus, and in case I hit, I don't know. Let's stop this thing and just play around this freaking Spell Pierce if they have it. Ah, Mengu. Alright, so we play all our hand basically and just play this thing and hope. A lot of hopes over here. I go to 5. So I need to like hit what? A Walking Ballista? Rise of Progress? Alright. Yeah, it's a loss. If I'd gone for Congregate Creator with a Spell Pierce backup, I could have gone for Lance of Diamond, I crack my hand, then I just play Bridge. I have no hand, I have a card in play. Yeah, I just eventually would have won, probably. Alright, yeah, whatever, what am I doing? Okay, so sideboarding, and alright, let's go with this. Playing better next game. At least I can get the feeling of being on the play. Let's see if, how does it feel. It feels fine. This hand is not that unfair, like many of the other hands that we had. I don't think I want to play this bubble, because I want to just follow it up to a mentor. When I play a mentor, that's uncounterable. So we're going to go plow. They're going to play their Delver, because, you know, whoever... Which Delver deck never plays... which Delver deck does not play Delver turn 1? Yeah, that's a good draw. I'm going to name Human, and then I'm going to plow. I could have gone for Walking Ballista, but I'd rather just... just chill my ballista in hand. There's not that these plows go... Yeah, like these plows could go into 1-3, and the Walking Ballista could go into Pyromancer, so it's all good. So I could go for Walking Ballista here. I think I'm gonna do that over playing Mentor Bubble. Yeah, I think so. So I'm gonna go Recover, Name, Construct, play Walking Ballista. And shoot the Pyromancer immediately. And now if they play Trainer Nemesis, I can't deal with that, unfortunately. But if they play 1-3, I can plow it. I saw a Pyromancer, fair enough. They play Prayer Dam. Do I want to just plow this? No, I don't think so. If I draw a Land Extender, I can just main phase plow. So I don't play Run Days, and then I just play Mentor Bubble. Mentor is uncounterable. So I basically want to play around Days as much as I can against these decks. They went top, at brutal land, okay. So I kick things off with a plow. All right, I'm gonna play a Mentor uncounterable. Not sure how good is this. We basically just killed a lot of the threats, that's it. I draw a card in their turn. Lightning Bolt, it's pretty good. So that's gone. I can just trade here. I honestly don't mind to just clear the board. Sure, they can have like something that I could block, but I mean, they played already three threats, so it was not that likely to just have another one, but it's okay. So let's draw for Bubble, Walking Ballista, that's nice. Yeah. Let's go Walking Ballista 2-2, that's pretty good, it's uncounterable. It's Cavernous Souls, I think it's being very good in this game. Like, I'm putting one top, and like, they have three cards, it's not that unlikely that they just have something, you know? Like a Force of Will or Spell Pierce or something. This Mox Opal is alive now. I go right on to Bold. Okay. Unfortunately, the Mox Opal does not add mana anymore, so I guess I can draw like an Ancient Dent to make it to play around Karn, to play around Spell Pierce, but yeah. My Wasteland, so now I can't even cast Karn. Okay, so no more humans uncounterable for me, but Chalice of the Void is nice. Unfortunately, I can't pay for Spell Pierce. Alright, I go 4, so I have 0 cards in hand. This is great, I have 0 cards in hand. And I have card. I can cast it, but... I have 0 cards in hand. They pass. Lotus Petal, alright, let's go. I don't even need to crack it, because I have Mox Opal now. Alright, please resolve. Alright, nice. Now it's between, if I go minus, they can just have a Lightning Bolt. They have played 2 already. So I think I'm just gonna go plus to play around these Lightning Bolts. Alright, flip plow and great creator, that's great. Great as a creator. As So the card has a silver counter. What's this? Treasure Arcanist. It's fine. I'm gonna plow that. For sure. Alright, so you have traitors. Let's plow that. Yeah, let's get the creator. Let's play it. I'm gonna play around spell piercer. What do you wanna get? I could get a walking ballista and then just don't play it. Or I just plus the Karn. Yeah, I think I'll plus the Karn. It's up to, so you can just go plus. You don't necessarily need to play into Lightning Bolt. We can just go minus next turn and play the Lattice and just win. So basically we win this game as a control deck. We played like 4 removals, but 5 removals. We played 3 plows and 2 walking ballista. Alright, that's the win. But nothing is uncounterable here. And if I go for the Lattice, I can even pay for... I guess it's better if you just play this. Then I just get the Landslide Diamond from the Congrid Creator. And then I just attempt to win. Which involves Landslide Diamond and Walking Ballista. Alright, so we beat this deck basically 3-0, I think, because like game 2 was kind of it. If we had, you know, played the where. Yeah, this might just be a good match. I mean, we did draw very well. They also did draw very well though, so I think this was a good match. Let's be back for round number 4. Alright, on the play this time around, finally we break the curse, guys. We break the curse. We are officially non-cursed, but we are. We haven't still break the curse of having Chalice on turn 1. That's a curse that we. I'd like to never break that curse, because if you just make a deck with Chalice of the Void, you always, the only thing you want to do is just doing this thing over and over and over. And if you are playing against the deck with Chalice of the Void, the only thing that you don't want to happen is this. Unless you smear match, then it's the worst thing you can do. But it's not the case. Alright, so just, whatever, just play random cards in this game. I just played Monster Mandarin to a couple of Urza's Bubble, which... I don't even know which sets are from. I'm so curious now, I didn't know which Egg and Paper, I mean. Magical Line, it's this Master Edition, but it's probably from, like, what? The Legends? I don't know, some obscure sets. Alright, so I pass. And I'm gonna just crack the bubbles because they do nothing right now. Mm-hmm. So opening a show and tell, looks like. The Omniscience, nice. And what else? Spell Pierce. Okay, nice. We draw 3 this turn. Basically Ancestor Recall delayed. I'm joking, of course, because you don't get to draw extra cards with the thing. Alright, I'm gonna need humans and I guess play Karn's Universe and just attempt to win. Very soon here, because this is 7 damage coming across and make a token, I think. I could dig for like a, let's say, diamond, but I think if I just make a token, it's a pretty big deal. Maybe not, I don't know. So if I make a token, it'll be just a 2-2, so next turn it can attack as a 3-3. Maybe more if I draw something good. So next turn, I don't have any spell unless I plus this card. So this is 7 damage, next turn could be not too much. I think I'm gonna just plus this. Which is a great Congrid Creator literally any time. I don't understand. I keep on playing. Alright, Petal and Mox. Okay, so get one more spell here. Sweet. Next turn I think should be the kill with the Arcs of Agers. I just rebuy a Petal and just play 2 times. It should be the kill. Alright. But my opponent also could kill us next turn. So be aware of that. It could go like Petal Sneak Attack. Raise a branch or 7 Emrakul, you're dead. Or just Emrakul since I'm on 14. Alright, if they thin their deck, because they feel like they're dead next turn, so they really need to just top deck now. Conic Wish. What is it gonna get though? Maybe Kha'Zix return?
Cossack Citadel would be annoying. I mean, it would just delay the kill for a couple of turns. Not even by that many, because the Karn just makes it probably just turn after they're dead again. So really hope they get Kozik's return. Alright, there it is. Nice. They also have to pay 2 to do that, so it's not that free. Alright, so they're on 5. Yeah, what do I do here? I could just... Yeah, I think I just minus this. Just play Arcs of Ages. Pass. Pass, and yeah, they're dead next turn, so it's all good. So they have to go off now. I guess I could have plused. Alright, this is probably a concession button. Hitting the concession button with this play, yeah. Alright, so playing against this Nikachu, Containment Priest is definitely good because it prevents an opponent from put into play anything. If a non-token creature would enter the battlefield, it wasn't cast, exactly. So both Sneak Attack and Show and Tell gets countered by that. I don't think I like Cast Out. I think Cast Out is mainly for just Planeswalkers like Jason Narset. And this time around, there's no artifact to bring in. So I could just keep on cutting my usual Karn Sandivers and Monster Mentor. I think that's just the base. And yep, let's go with this. Okay, so isn't this weird? Because I could power a Savagers into play, but I don't think this is. Maybe, you know what? Let's just keep it. Because I'm just like I'm missing like Lands and Diamond to win, like not to win, but like to go off. But I have Cavern of Souls to make my combo uncountable. So yes, I'm playing against a combo deck, but I don't necessarily need to mulligan into that because I'm also a combo deck myself. Alright, so can I play that turn 1? I guess I can, it's funny, but I think I can play Karn Sandivers turn 1, funnily enough. It's pretty impressive. I mean, they could have a Spell Pierce, so probably I shouldn't do that. Yeah, I don't think I should do that, yeah. I don't know what I'm doing right now, but I'm just gonna play all these and just play a Counter Source and pass. This is Island App, I don't want to play into Spell Pierce just that much. Because not only I just waste the pedal, but I also just waste the Seed of Traitors. Whereas next turn I can just safely play my Arcs of Ages. And like if I top deck a Lands Eye Diamond, I draw a lot of cards, you know? And also if I don't... Right now I don't want to crack my bubble. Because if I crack my bubble, the Mox Opal doesn't add mana immediately next turn. Sure, I could top deck something for it, but maybe it's just not going to be a turn I'm worrying too much. No, there isn't. It could go like Intuition or the other thing, but again, it's just going to let it resolve. All right, Lance of Demo, please. Containment Priest, wow. All right, change of plan. I just passed the turn here. And I even have Cavern of Souls. That's impressive. Alright, I could crack the bubble now. I think I'll crack the bubble because like they have a good card on top, I feel like. Unless they shuffle. If they shuffle, I'm going to just decide an upkeep. Let's see if they play like an Intuition or a Cunning Wish. Because I couldn't shuffle the deck. I think I just want to draw another card because I really want to... Their problem is if I... Nah, you know what? You know what? It's fine. I'm just going to continue press end of turn no matter what. I really wish they go... Show and Tell this turn. The problem with Sneak Attack is that if to flip Show and Tell, it's gonna be great. Don't do that. All right, I'm just gonna play Containment Priest no matter what because I kind of mana tight here, mana constraint here. So Containment Priest is uncounterable. All right. All right, stuck first. And I'm not worried about, what do I do? Do I just go Arcs of Ages or do I go Karn? Because Karn can play around Spell Pierce. That's probably the play, right? Yeah, I'm gonna go Karn out of Spell Pierce range. Kinda wish I had a Monster Mentor, but... Over Karn Sandiversa. Maybe I should have just 4 Monster Mentor always, and not this Karn Sandiversa. The fact that this draws a card is kind of appealing, though. I'm probably just gonna make a token and just attack here. Because I want to just clock my opponent. Because this is a 5-5, it's gonna be a 6-6 next turn. At least. I think I'm gonna crack the bubble this time around. Alright, what do they get? And also for the containment priest, maybe. It's through the breach also. We stopped this through the breach as well. Why do I get intuition? That's a lot of pass of you know, cards to get through. Actually, I don't want to crack this bubble. I think one more damage is more important. Because deal 6 now, so that, I don't know, not even a wipe away saves them. Alright, if they kill this, they still die. Yeah, I don't think I want to redraw the card. This is a good one. Alright, so let's play Chalice for 1. I could play Chalice for 3, maybe? Is that good? I would just crack too many petals. I don't know. I kind of feel like I want to play. No, I'll just play this. I think they have Spell Pierce from the way they played. Like, if you remember, they went Island Go, so I really want to play around Spell Pierce if I can. Alright, play Spell Pierce. So, this resolves. Pay 2. Yes. This is probably just... If they have... Okay, that's good. So if I go minus here, I think I will go minus, yes. Just dealing 9 damage. They deal them 2, that, like, so that they have 2 lethal threat next turn. And if they go like wipe away on one, they still die to the other. Sure, if they go like work his recall, whatever, I mean, what did they lose? Just the possibility of going current plus. I don't think that it's that big of a miss. So they go intuition, but what do they do here? Remember, I have a containment priest. So even if they go like, I don't know, let's see. I'm interested. Like, the answer for containment priests usually are just sudden shock. Alright, I'm gonna crack this bubble. I guess I should have cracked in my turn, so that I could have drawn something big and just played in with show and tell. Pyroclasm on top. It's a very lucky opponent. It's very lucky. Alright, I could die now. Because of that. Maybe they had a line. Oh yeah. I didn't think about it. I did not think about it. But if they go show and tell omniscience, they can win through the containment priest, maybe. Yeah, this way. I mean, this doesn't win. I mean, if they didn't draw the pyroclasm. This doesn't win. Wait, where is my... Oh my god, I just forgot. Oh, I just realized they didn't just put into play a thing through omniscience. Alright, it's funny. Okay. Alright, I'm very happy I went for the construct. Not that it matters, but yeah, if you have a containment priest, don't put a creature into play with the show and tell. Alright, so that's a redraw. The card I could have played it with. This says only. Alright, I go pyroclasm. It's pretty good. I go cunning wish. Yeah, I guess I'll lose. What do they find? No, they don't have another intuition. Paramount foresight. Alright. Remember there's a chalice. But I can go like maybe intuition for 3 Grizzlebrand. That'll win. Alright, I go Cunning Wish and Impulse. Alright. And Brazen, of course. I guess they can go Cunning Wish to answer my... I guess they have an Orcus recall. Release the ants. Sure. Release the ants doesn't do it. Let's say Impulse. Alright, sneak attack, sure. Do they have Razorbrand? Alright. Good game. At the end of the day, the containment priest doesn't matter too much if they have omniscience, but you know. We still boarded it in. Alright, definitely gonna have a third mantle over Sign of Urza. And I don't think I want to cast out. I guess cast out does deal with omniscience, but it just comes at a very expensive cost. And then like the Sign of Urza does pressure my opponent, so I think I don't wanna cut too many combo cards. I have like 12 cards. It's not that Earth's Evasion does too much if I don't have Lens of Diamond though, but yeah, I think this is enough. I don't want cast out. Alright. Game 3 against Sneak Attack. It's a mulligan. And, alright, let's keep this. I need to draw either a 0 mana card or a artifact. Or sorry, either a 0 mana artifact or a land next turn to be able to play Containment Priest on time. I cannot use the Argus, so the reason is if I use this bubble, I get to redraw and draw the land. I think it's better to use it. I think it's better to use it, yeah. It's like, sure, now the Mox Opal it's further away, but I think I just need to hit a land next turn. Like, I guess if I don't crack this, I can also just draw a zero drop. That's relevant, right? And I have, what? 16. So right now, if I just crack the bubble, this is just math. This is just math, so I have no clue. I mean, I was good at math at school, but, you know, this is not a level. Because, like, if I crack, I draw two cards, so I have two shots at drawing one of these 19, I guess 18. But if I draw naturally, I could draw one of these 16, not the opal though, so one of these 12. So I think it's more better if I just draw a card. And that revealed me a force of will, which is not bad. So I redraw, does the plants immediately, and the petals. So I got both. I have both here. And I just passed the turn. I mean, they're force of will, so I might just wait to have I guess I should have boarded out at least now that I think about it. I might just wait to cast this Containment Priest. To wait because I could draw a Cavern of Souls. Actually I could play Containment Priest regardless now. No, I think I'm happy with the cracking. I mean, of course it went well. But I don't know. Alright, so I don't want to throw away this Containment Priest end of turn. Remember, if I didn't go for Walking Ballista, the Mox Opal is not live, so I couldn't have gone on Containment Priest Karn. Like, for sure, you know? Wow, another of that. Okay, what did I keep? Alright. Again, I don't want to play Containment Priest here. Cavern. Mox Opal, alright. Yeah, I mean, I can cast Karn. I'd rather just throw away a Mox Opal than a Petal, I guess. I mean, do I? No, I think it's better if I throw away a Petal. Yeah. They have Force of Will revealed, so I don't think I want to just save myself the Containment Priest mana. I'd rather just play Karn, which also shuts down the only Quarterless source they have. So maybe I was supposed to just bait. But I wasn't sure that I would have drawn it. I guess I had the 4 mana. No, because if I go end of turn Containment Priest, then I don't have 4 mana because the petal dies. Alright. So maybe if I just go Containment Priest end of turn, cracking the petal, they go 4s, and then I top deck a land. But then the Mox Opal doesn't work, the Mox Opal. So keep that in mind. The Mox Opal doesn't work. Alright, I'll lose again. I lose even regardless of the... Contemporary isn't even good against this version, honestly, guys. Alright, yeah, I mean, if you don't know the combo, I mean, I just recorded with this earlier, but yeah, they just go Intuition for 3 Armor Cool. I mean, this version is slightly different. They also have Sneak Attack. It's probably better. But yeah, maybe if I go Contemporary Priest end of turn, though, I cannot cast Karn. Because the Mox Opal does not mana, because the petal died. Alright. Yeah, this is the game. Alright, good game. We're 2-2, let's see if we can throw together 2-3. Sorry, 3-2. Alright, this is our last round with this deck. Let's see how it goes, and we are in a play once again. So that's very good. This hand is also very good. I'm gonna go with Cavern of Souls past the turn, naming humans. And next turn I can go City of Traders, Mentor, two things, and then next turn I can Float Mana and play Khan, Great Creator. So that's a pretty good combination. That is a pretty good combination indeed. So let's just name humans and pass. I was very close to play Mentor turn 1 actually, because Ancient Dan, Mox Opal, and Lands of Dam would give me 2 mana turn 1. But unfortunately 2 mana is not enough. Alright, upon their shuffle, nice. Where is this bobble? Alright, let's go for it. So, mentor. Play this way just so I maybe make one more mana with the Mox Opal. I know they could have gone ancient to ancient and I would have just, you know, saved the Seed of Traders, but I would have lost on two tokens. And I don't know what's the matchup, but those things usually matters. I'm just gonna play all of them because my opponent could just have Lightning Bolt. Alright, and now I'll pass. I'm just gonna crack the bubble in my opponent's turn. Alright, what is this? Just another environment? Alright. Play against all the Izzet deck today. Alright, on top of the deck there is a brain. Now in their hand is brain, so I'm sure. Okay, we got everything, guys. We just have everything. Yeah, I mean this is it. Just play a Savage was uncounterable. Let's play the Savage is uncounterable. Then they got 3 mana of the Lensei Diamond. At 4 mana, so even if they have Force of Will, I win this game. I mean, I win, yeah. This is it. This is over. This is it. Even if they have Force of Will for my first Lensei Diamond. Yeah, so I float his mana now. And then I discard it all. I have 4 mana in my pool. I return the Lensei Diamond. I play it. And then if I put in this Force of Will, I'll just buy it back again. And that's it. Wow, this is a turn 3 kill. It's impressive. Kinda need to screenshot this, because turn 3 kill with this deck, I did not expect it, but yeah, this is it. Also through Force of Will. Okay, a turn 3 kill through Force of Will. Like they couldn't counter anything that we did. Like literally anything. Alright, yeah, I guess we perfection the other cyborg guy during this game, so let's go. Game 2, what do we have? I mean this Chalice of the Void, I don't want much more. I don't want much more. You can't say that we're winning these games always because we only have Chalice of the Void in our opener, which is probably true. All right. Splurge Chalice on 1. Probably gonna get dates, but I did. Wow, the result. I didn't want to just throw away Seed of Traders on turn 1. Like, playing Seed on turn 1, it has a big cost. And even if I put in dates, this, you know. Sure, it's very bad, but. All right. So if they pass here, it means that they have an abrade on the Chalice. If they wasteland me. Probably doesn't mean that. Alright, I played that. I could go Karn. And play a bridge. To resolve that fast. Alright, and I'm gonna go bridge here. I'll discard a Chalice, but I think it's fine. Should definitely crack the bubble. Actually, no, I had, maybe yes. I don't know, whatever. I don't think my opponent does a Force of Will. So let's play this bridge. And, this time around, I'm gonna crack the bubble. Dates on top of their deck. Interesting. Good to know. So if they have an abrade, I can kill my. If they can kill my Karn, that's bad. Alright, I do have an abrade. So I kind of lost it all because I also lost a second Chalice. I could have played for 2 mana. Maybe that would have been safer. Do you have any 2 drop in this deck? No, maybe I should have played Chalice for 2. That would have been just very safe. Instead, I just lost everything. Alright, yeah, they have a Mentor in hand, but. Sorry, a Lightning Bolt in hand, but I can't cast it through the Chalice. Just have a Daze. Which they're probably gonna play here. Alright, let's pay. Should have not played Ancient Tomb. Alright. So they have a Lightning Bolt in hand, hopefully some more one drops. This game I should have just went for turn, whatever was it, 2-3, Chalice on 2, instead of Karn into Bridge. Because now in order for me to deal with this, it's pretty hard. Like, I need to draw Plow on the Ascent Aberration, then it kind of stabilizes, but I need to draw Plow first. Walking Ballista does not do it, unfortunately. I'm still going to play it. Because if I just draw any land, I just put a counter on it and then shoot the insect aberration. I have a force. Actually, Plow doesn't do it because it's Chalice. It's kind of awkward to have Plow and Chalice in the same deck. Yeah, I think I just lose this now. Alright. Obviously, like, this first league with this deck, there's a lot of things that, you know, we're learning slowly, but yeah, there's no out at this point. Alright. Okay, so next game, if we have a situation like this, I'm gonna just drop a Chalice on 2. The second Chalice would have just been on 2 instead of just discarding it to a Deadline's Eye Diamond. Where is the second Chalice? Oh, it's still in play. Yeah, alright, good game. Be back for round number 3. My final game of these very quick games. Alright, this is not a Chalice on 1, unfortunately. Despite it looked very close. Despite seemed very, very close to do that. I'm just gonna crack all the bubble in the word and just see to draw a land to play Chalice. There's a Lightning Bolt on top. Then they pass. Alright, I'm gonna crack this as well. It's a Lightning Bolt on top, nice. Alright. So let's draw 4 cards this turn. Even better, Ancestral Eagle. So looking for a land here, but it could have a Spell Pierce though. Alright. Play Chalice of the Void. So they're gonna go Spell Pierce and I'll pass the turn. This time around I didn't have to play Lands of Damage. I don't wanna discard a card. Let that resolve. Sorry, discard a hand to let that resolve, so it's all good. So they will not draw the Lightning Bolt because they shuffled. Mm-hmm. Next turn, I'm gonna try to play Karn Great Creator, and I'm gonna play Lands of the Hammond first this time around. They have Lightning Bolt in hand, so I'm not gonna play my Mentor here. Just gonna go Karn and hope they don't have Force of Will. I think I can beat everything else. Alright, it's resolved. So if I go minus 3, I get Lattice, they just bolt the Karn. So it's not great. So it's gonna plus it and pass here. Because I can just crack these, get Lattice, but they just have a Lightning Bolt in hand, so you can knock a plus. And it's your go. They could have double Lightning Bolt, but they have a second Great Creator. I would play 4 Great Creator in this deck. Like, this is just the combo kill. It's not like the other card. Which, sure, I mean, at this point, the other card would just get me a card. But this one just wins next turn. I mean, Puna could float mana and abrade it. And abrade the Lattice, sure. Alright, I keep on cantripping. But I didn't have... What did you do with Ponder earlier? I didn't see that. They shuffled with Ponder, and now they went top though. Okay. Maybe just Ponder Delver. Like, the thing is that, if I want to get Lattice here, I have to discard my hand, which I probably don't want to. I could just get a... This is not an artifact, so I can't get it. Because this only gets artifact. Okay, Caesar Treasure is number 2. So, yeah, I'm gonna just play... Let's just play Mentor and then Karn. No, I don't want to play another Karn. What do I play? Maybe I just reanimate. Maybe I just get Bridge. Just play the odd combination Mentor Bridge. Yeah, why not, right? I mean, I think Karn on 4 is fine. And I don't think I want to go for Lattice here. Yeah, I'm just gonna get Bridge. Like, I could go Walking Ballista, but that doesn't seem that good to me. I could get Bobble. I mean, nah, I'm gonna get a Bridge, it's fine. So let's play Mentor and let's play Bridge. And I play this way so that if opponent is lineable on Mentor, I still get a token, which is somewhat relevant. I mean, my opponent is playing like this as a control, even though they let the card resolve, which is interesting. All right, so I lose that one, and it's your turn, opponent. Yeah, I lose the mana. Activating Bridge to attack, it's not a good play, because the Bridge just can't attack through its own Bridge. Kind of awkward if you animate the Bridge, and then the Bridge can't attack through its own Bridge. I mean, not even to its own, it's just to itself. It's kind of weird. It's like, alright, it goes surgical on my Mentor. Alright, bye-bye Mentors. I do have Walking Abilities in the sideboard to just attack. And that can do it. And that can easily do that through the Bridge. I wish that exiled the Chalice. I could not get the Chalice because this has you can get outside of the game, so in the sideboard or in exile. So if the opponent decides to surgical my Chalices, I can just minus two and get the Chalice as well. So to play the Lightning Bolt, that we knew. All right, so we don't know anything in their hand. Hopefully, they just have a bunch of dirtling cards. Like that was not bad. I think I need to just make my. I'm just gonna go for Lattice this time around. And if I go Lattice, I win here. I think. Right? So let's play Bubble. I need to crack a Lensei Diamond, but I think I'm gonna do it. So I'm gonna go minus, get Lattice. Yes. Mikos into Lattice. Porcaeva. Oh my god, guys, made such a big mistake here. It's kind of unbelievable. Mistake that I've made. Should have cracked Lensei Diamond first. Oh my god, I can't believe I made the mistake. Alright, let's try to recover. I just won the game. I'm not gonna publish this video, I don't mind. I don't mind showing some puns here and there. Alright. Yes. So let's get Walking Ballista. Let's kill the Dreadlord Arcanist. Alright. It's making the game more interesting, I guess. Next turn, if I survive. Like, if my Karn survives, I mean. They could just kill the Bridge with an Abrade and then attack Karn if this flips. So let's hope it doesn't flip. Alright, flips. Ugh. All right, so the thing is, once again, you just crack Lines of Diamond first and then get Lattice with Karn and then you just win, but I sequenced that wrong, so I just basically lost everything, but it's okay. I could still get Thormos Crypt off the Karn, examine graveyard, and then get Karn. All right, never mind, Karn's dead. All right, just once again, just making this game more interesting, I guess, but yeah, we would have been in such a good shape. I mean, we would have just won the game effectively. All right, Arcanist in hand, Chalice and Ballista. Oof. All right, I guess I'm gonna go Chalice for two here, so they can cast Arcanist and Abrade. I mean, the Arcanist couldn't have talked through the Bridge, so maybe I should have just killed the Ballista to just, you know, get in. But eventually, maybe the Arcanist could have attacked through the Bridge last turn. Alright, what is this one? They don't click. Sure. All right. Mm-hmm. I'll pass. So we need to draw the last current grid creator. All right, this is not a bit, no, it's not a bad one. I need to be a little bit worried of the ancient tomb lands. I'm just gonna play this for one, I think. This might be the game I've made more mistake in my life. And that means they kind of spiraling, and this is funny. Like, watching this could be actually be funny. Because if we win somehow, kind of shows how, it kind of shows how many, like, the name of the game here could just be how many mistakes a person can make and still win the game. Thanks to a snaring bridge. Probably, it's probably the name of the game. All right. So I hope their hand's currently just 20,000 two drop. Like, the fun thing is that I think that the only way they can deal with my chalice is just not braid. Imagine having the walking ballista in play. All right. Chase for one. Oh, boy, again? How is it impossible? Alright, the lightning bolt face. I guess they were afraid of my lightning, my chalice. Which makes sense, I mean, I would also be afraid of my chalice. Alright, so how many lightning bolts do I have left? They only have one lightning bolt. I don't think they can. Maybe they can't bolt me out. Just gonna draw. Redraw. I'm just looking for Congrate Creator. Arcs of Ages also. It's pretty good. Mm-hmm. I think we got this, guys. I think we got this. Alright, draw Braid. Good. Can't cast it though. Can't cast it though. Alright, I think we got this. I think we got this. The game with the where I played two times suspending to my chalice on two. And the game where I used card minus before getting the card with lines at diamond. But luckily we drew Arcs of Ages and we got there. Alright, we went 3-2 in this league. We lost to Sneak and Show and Reanimator. The Reanimator game was weird. If I wasn't a player, I would have won, I think, game one. The Sneak and Show game was cool. And the three times we beat Blue Red, despite not knowing what we were doing. I hope this still was entertaining. The level of play was definitely lower than the last one with Crisis Control. That one is my pet deck. This one, it's like something new, and playing something new every time is not, it's not that easy. I hope you guys can be nice with me, hopefully. But I'm sure that in the chat, you can't wait to see how bad this was. But yeah, next time I'll try to pay more attention to my chalices and to my, I guess, just the combination of card and lines of diamond. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll be back for more Legacy videos next time. Don't forget to subscribe to ChannelFireball and see you next time. Goodbye.